I'm Jamie, registered dietitian, and this is Elizabeth, our social media expert.
Hi.
She's going to assist me in showing you how to make our favorite fall recipe, which is the pumpkin spice recipe, to help you fall into the fall season. So, Elizabeth.
Yes.
What we have going on today is a couple of things to create our pumpkin spice recipe. Mm-hmm. But first, let's go over the equipment you'll need.
Right.
You'll need a blender. Alright, you can get away with one of those shaker bottles, mm-hmm. but ideally for this recipe you want to use a blender. And here we have our fantastic Ninja blender here, which really breaks up that pumpkin puree that we're
right.
going to be using for this recipe. So it's a very simple recipe.
Mm-hmm.
It's not far from the instructions or the ingredients that you use from our classic recipe.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so ready to get started?
Yes, sounds great.
Okay, so while I make this recipe, Elizabeth is going to be asking some of your frequently asked questions. But if you happen to have some while we're making this shake, make sure you put them in the comments of this video and we'll be sure to answer them afterwards.
Yes, leave them there. So my first question I'm going to ask that we get a lot of is, can this be used on the first phase, or when is this a good shake to use?
Okay, so phase one of the program,
mm-hmm.
we want it to be as clean as possible.
Mm-hmm.
So for that phase, I want you to use a clean recipe, which is our classic recipe.
Okay.
It's just the unsweetened almond milk, a dash of cinnamon, and that's it. We're trying to reduce those sugar craving, helping you to reset your metabolism.
Mm-hmm.
And not only that, we're keeping it low calories. That way you lose the weight fast, and that'll keep you motivated throughout the whole program.
Right.
And for this recipe, it's more for phase two, or for those who just want a healthy alternative for
mm-hmm.
a breakfast. You know, they're waking up early in the morning, they don't have time to fix up anything, so they just want something on the go, and this is a great alternative for
right.
them. So this recipe will require 12 ounces of unsweetened almond milk. So you pour it into the blender like
mm-hmm.
so. And you want to pour the liquid in first.
Okay.
Because later on when we add the powder, which is the almond scent powder, we don't want it to stick to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And that way you'll be wasting, you know, some of the important
right.
nutrients from almond scent. So that is the unsweetened almond milk, 12 ounces of that. And then we add in the 2 tablespoons of pureed pumpkin. And you can puree your own pumpkin,
mm-hmm.
you know, if you're into carving pumpkins,
right.
and later on you can scoop out those pumpkin. I mean, that's just so much fun if you do that with your kids, right? But, you know, if you don't have time, you can purchase the 100% natural pureed pumpkin in a can, which, you know, it's low in sugar and there's lots of vitamin A, and I would definitely go with that if you're on the go. So we'll scoop in the pureed pumpkin. There we go. Make sure we get all of it. And it
mm-hmm.
smells so good already.
It does smell good. It's like fall.
Yep. And let's see what's next. And you can find these recipes online, by the way. Just go to almased.com and then click on the recipe tab. You'll be able to view this recipe specifically. And it's the pumpkin spice recipe. All right. Next, after that, you add in the teaspoon of oil.
So that's another question that we get on Facebook a lot, is why you need oil in the shake and what's the best kind of oil to use?
Okay, so first of all, with the almased, it doesn't have fat in it, you know, so it's important that when you are fasting on the program, you are getting healthy fats.
Mm-hmm.
So adding the teaspoon of oil is going to be best for you nutritionally.
Mm-hmm.
It also has a lot of omega-3s, which is very important for your overall health.
Right.
It has brain health benefits as well as cardiovascular benefits. And not only that, it further improves the metabolism and it adds a little bit of calories to help you stay full longer on the diet.
That's important.
If you don't like the taste of the oil, you know, you can have it in different ways, but
mm-hmm.
I highly suggest that, especially if you're on the fasting, that you add a teaspoon or two to all of your shakes.
Okay.
And the best oil to use, I suggest, is olive oil, flaxseed oil, or walnut oil.
Okay.
Some people want to try the coconut oil,
mm-hmm.
you know, that's a health trend and
right.
it tastes delicious. And you can do that coconut oil every once in a while, but I highly suggest going with the olive oil, flaxseed oil, or walnut oil because it just has a higher omega 3 to omega 6 ratio.
Mm-hmm.
And our body needs both types of omegas.
Right.
But the thing is, our diet is typically has so much more omega 6s that when you add omega 3s, that's definitely going to benefit you a lot more. It has anti-inflammatory benefits,
mm-hmm.
which a lot of us need.
That makes sense. Thank you.
Okay, so that's the oil and a teaspoon of the pumpkin spice.
It smells so
yeah.
good.
Yeah, it does already. So I'm just going to add a little bit of that or a lot of it.
I like a lot.
Yeah, I like a lot. Let's see here. And then we've already opened this can. I mean, we only have a serving left of this can, so we're just going to go ahead and dump it in here without the spoon.
So that's like another question we get a lot is about how do you know how much amaretto you should use in a shake? And does it depend on weight or height or how
right.
does that work?
So originally in our instructions, we said, you know, if you are 5'5" or below, you consume 6 tablespoons. If you are 5'6" and taller, you
mm-hmm.
consume 8 tablespoons.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like it's based on height, but in actuality, we made a couple of scientific calculations. And then we simplified the chart just to make it easier for everyone to choose which would be the right amount of protein
mm-hmm.
for their height or their size. But in general, you know, if in doubt, just use the full 8 tablespoons.
Okay.
It won't hurt just to have a little bit of added protein to your shake.
Okay, good. That's
okay,
easy.
So that's it. I mean, I did add a little bit more pumpkin spice than what it's asked for, but that's just going to give it some more flavor. So the beauty of amaretto is that you can play with the flavors and make it taste like how you want it.
So could you add ice to this if you wanted it to be like an iced pumpkin spice?
Yes, absolutely. You can add ice either before or after. You can add crushed ice to it.
Mm-hmm.
I would say anywhere between 3 to 6 ice cubes
mm-hmm.
is enough. Alright, so we're going to put it on. Yellow to more of a pumpkin spice
mm-hmm.
color.
Okay, that beautiful orange.
Yeah. And this is enough for one serving, but Elizabeth and I, since it's the middle of the day, we're going to have it as a snack, so
share
we'll split it.
It
up. Yeah, we'll share it. Let's see, I'm a little clumsy, so everything needs to be poured on the table.
Alright.
And yours here. So another thing I didn't add here is stevia. If you like it to taste a little sweet, you can purchase, you know, packets of natural sweeteners like stevia and put it into your shake. If you like cold coffee, which we do have a pumpkin spice latte recipe, you can just pour it right in. So this is actually 1 ounce of leftover cold coffee that I had from this morning. And I'm just going to pour it into my latte because I love that coffee flavor. And that's it.
Cheers.
Cheers.
So one last question that we get a lot, and that is, where can you buy amaretto?
So amaretto, you could purchase it at our major pharmacies, which is Walgreens, CVS, and then also our nutrition stores like GNC and the Vitamin Shop. You can also shop online, Amazon.com, to find amaretto.
Great.
Great.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yum.
Mm,
it's
so
delicious.
Yeah.
Fall in a cup.
Yeah, it feels so great to have fall and winter around in Florida soon.
Yeah.
Thank you all for watching.
Thank you. And don't forget to send in your comments
yeah,
or questions.
Don't forget to send in your comments. If you have any questions, just leave them in the comments. I'll be sure to answer them online or in our next video.